I would like to begin by showing you a brief interview with a brain-based learning expert that visited my classroom this week.
Elizabeth, tell me a little bit about your warm-up activities. I think it's fantastic that you have warm-ups, but explain to me some of the questions and some of the ways you can apply brain-based learning to those questions in order to enhance the warm-up activity for your students that they might be a little more engaged. Yes, the warm-up activities. These are things that I want them to come to class excited about. I want them to come in and be like, I wonder what that next question is going to be that Miss Clower is going to ask us. And I've, you know, thought about different ways to do it, sometimes doing like a pair share before they write their response, but I would like to be more consistent about that, where they can talk about it, express to each other what their opinions are, and then write it down, regardless of the question. And yes, the question forming should be also changed a little bit. But at the same time, I think it's important at least a couple times a week to incorporate some personal things like, you know, what is something that happened this week that you're really like ticked off about, or they can have a time and they talk about it with someone, or if that's too personal, something like your favorite type of music, your favorite color, your favorite foods, and why, or what do you like to do in your free time. I like my students to know each other on a personal basis. I only have them for 40 minutes a day, so it's really tough, but if we do that in the first 5 minutes of class, I think it'll mean a lot to them. So those are some of the things I've been brainstorming about how to do the warm-up activities and how to get them excited to come in and be able to validate themselves, and not only in their knowledge of the content that they're learning, but within themselves and who they are personally, and being able to share that with another student and finding things that they have in common with someone who maybe they don't ever hang out with or they don't ever get to know. So doing a little bit of that kind of class building stuff is definitely something I'll want to incorporate and do more of that pair share stuff for sure. Excellent, excellent. I am so glad you pointed that out. Also, I was wondering about the some videos of what ways you can change the experience for your students as you're viewing a Brain Pop, for example, which you did this week, and also another short video clip, which I believe you also showed to your 8th grade U.S. history class about the California Gold Rush. What are some ways you can apply those things to real life, or some ways you can appeal to certain emotions that the students have, or maybe some goals in their lives, viewing brain-based learning in that? Video clips are tough because I think they're great for our visual learners, but at the same time, I don't want them to just see it and take it in and be like, oh great, that was a nice boring video. And yeah, Brain Pops are great. They're kind of in cartoon form. But I recently started having them choose their own activity to do on Friday. And one of those is a skit. And they get really excited when I videotape their skits because they, you know, they're like, I want to be on YouTube. So for them to reenact and create some type of, I know we're working toward this because in 40 minutes it's really hard to get together with a plan and a script and make a great movie clip, but something that's in the works where maybe they can have a couple days to work on it, and maybe even more than that. If I see that there's learning going on, then that's something I want to work toward, where they can even work to edit their own movies and add effects, and it could be a learning tool for years to come for my future classes and serve as examples. But so that's definitely one way. And then another way is maybe to even offer the option, like if you want to learn more about this, like watch this video clip. Of course, ideally, I would have at least a computer in the class so that students can share them. But maybe someone would rather look in a textbook to find information. Someone would rather watch a video. Someone would rather search on the internet. So I would love to have different stations where people can go, like watch this video on this and all of that. But and yeah, to make it life applicable, how can you relate the California Gold Rush to something currently, like in life, like today that's happening in the news around us? Or, you know, what are people willing to go out and get just to see if they can strike it rich and make lots of money? Like, trying to get to the motivation of all of that. And maybe ask them if you know, knowing what you know now, would you go to the West, to California, and try to find gold, even though you probably weren't going to strike it rich anyway? So what are some alternatives? What could these people have done to improve the situation? So that whole decision-making, that critical thinking, it needs to be a component for sure. But man, this has been a tough week, but it's also been great, and I really appreciate your help. Even though our students are technologically savvy, they still deal with everyday things that students have always dealt with, such as emotions and whether or not you got invited to that birthday party and extracurricular activities like sports, things like money, always money on the mind, thinking about their future, possessions, how they can have a good life. But at this age, they focus on approval, their peers' approval and acceptance. This past week, the brain expert gave me a thumbs up for this one. I have a student who is normally not motivated by anything to do any work. He loves attention, though. Of course, he loves approval from his peers. But this just incorporated all of that stuff. And multiple intelligences, tapping into their strengths, allowing choice and creativity. He loves to rap. And him and another student got together and they each created their own rap song about the things that we were learning in class. And it was an incredible piece of work. Amazing. I was so excited. They're excited to keep it, practice it, perform it, and so I can record them next week. But that was just a great time during the week, and we all had fun.